You know, a lot of things are going on, and it kind of sounds like war talk, and it certainly isn't. I'm talking about trade talk, taxes, and just being competitive. How do you compete with somebody that is so different than you in a positive way? Where I'm going with this thing is that Canada now is debating hiking stacks more on small businesses and all the humanoids in Canada, and it's kind of bizarre because, you know what, I think 7% of all Canadians actually earn more than $100,000 a year, and those people, that small little group of folks, they pay about 60% of all of the taxes. And Trudeau's saying, you know what, we need to punish you some more, and he's working on that. I mean, I get the tax thing. We're all happy to pay taxes if you got a kind of sort of maybe, why not? I'm here to help the masses of the great unwashed. However, when it's being wasted, when you're giving taxes to people like that, to liberals, it's kind of like, I don't know, think about your neighbor, and he's a drunk, and he's a gambler, and every day you give him money, and you watch him throw it away. But if he's hungry, it's okay. Give him money, pay his rent, help him, I get it. But if he's wasting all of the money, and it's your money, that's kind of not so nice. And Trump is now saying, guys, I'm going to fix this. And he is going to fix it. And Canada will be distinctly offside. You know, how do you keep people in your country? A doctor, an entrepreneur, how do you keep them when you're going to charge them soon, probably be as high as 60%, when they can go south and pay 15 or whatever that number will be? And I got to tell you, I got a prediction. I kind of think there'll be no personal income tax in the United States of America over the course of the next 2 to 3 year time period. I believe that. I think that Trump will probably legalize marijuana countrywide, and he'll take that as a tax base and say, now we're good. All you people's kind of going back to World War One when income tax was brought in as a temporary measure. Maybe this is wishful thinking, but you know what? Anything is possible with Mr. Trump, don't you think? In Canada, there's a Conservative member of Parliament. Her name is Candace Bergen, and she's mad at the Liberals. She wanted to go to China with them, and China wouldn't give her a passport a couple of days before she left, and she's crabby about all that. And you know what, Candace? I know Candace pretty well. Her and I have met before a few times, and Candace, get over it. Who wants to ride in an airplane full of commies? Anyway, going to commie land. Blah, stay at home and do some good stuff. Now, recent elections in Germany, people are shocked. People, I don't know if they're really people, they're left-wing whack people, all the people on the other side, and they're coming to Canada now to have meetings, love fest, kind of some hugging going to be going on with Trudeau and all of his commie friends, and saying, how do we prevent this from happening? We haven't had a right-wing guy since Hitler. That always makes me bristle. Really? You think he was right-wing? I'm right-wing. How dare you? I don't think Hitler was right-wing. I mean, because he took people's choices away. That would be more left-wing, I would kind of want to say to you. But in any event, she's so concerned, back to this one woman, many left-wing whack women in Germany, she's saying, how do we stop this from happening? We're all shocked. Well, first, maybe do what the people want. You know, like the million refugees and all the people coming in, the people don't really want that. I mean, it's about the people, or it should be about the people in any event. A terror attack happened in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. Long pause there. Hey, get over it. So many people think that can't happen in Canada. It can. You got back to that prime minister. You got an unbalanced guy. He and all of his administration, they can't bring enough people in. I mean, you got high unemployment in Canada. You got all kinds of men and women who are born and raised there. They can't get a job, and he's bringing in people from other countries constantly, and they're all these radical guys. Not all. Pardon me. Let me back up on that. We don't know if they are or not. Certainly some are. The rumor is, I haven't heard it yet as a fact, but the guy who did that terrorist attack in Edmonton, that he was, you know, one of the ones that Trudeau brought in or allowed in or something. But you know what? This thing is wild. You got to have a handle on it. These are the same guys that then turn around and say, hey, you good guys, you can't be armed. You can't defend. Rah, I could go on and on. You all come back tomorrow and we'll have another chat. It's about solutions. What is the solution? Well, firstly, you get rid of all the liberals. You got to somehow get them out. But how do you do that? Because it's not necessarily who votes that counts, it's who counts the vote. So you got to really be watchful. You got to think about all this, and you got to get rid of those guys. That's the solution. Hey, see ya.